All aboard!
Hello and welcome to another episode of the Woodsman Whack Off, the series that puts two woodsmen face to face to see which competitor can whack off their log the fastest. In today's episode, we are facing off two very unlikely competitors, the Steel MS660 and the Echo 590 Timberwolf. The MS660 is a full-tilt boogie professional felling saw designed to slay big timber all day, every day. It is 92 cc's of power at the squeeze of a trigger. This particular 660 might actually be an 066, but it's the same saw, really. It has been equipped with a West Coast bark box and a Max Flow air filter setup. The Echo 590 Timberwolf is a 59cc saw that is meant as a semi-pro unit for farm and ranch duty. This particular 590 has been muffler modded and carburetor modded by blocking off the extra port in the high jet to allow for the proper tuning of the carburetor. This is Hot Rod's personal saw that he calls the Dire Wolf. Our operators of the day? On the Dire Wolf, his favorite smell is hangover and his favorite color is flannel. His name is Hot Rod, best damn chainsaw mechanic in South Fulton. On the 660, he loves chainsaws and he loves his mama. He is, of course, Soft Hand Steve, the annoying sales and marketing guy. Alrighty then, let's get this party started. Hot Rod says he's ready to go with his cap turned around backwards and his safety sunglasses. I hear he wears those safety sunglasses at night even. Alright, so here we are on the gentle slide down the shaft, and it looks clearly like the 660 is going to walk away with that win. But you know, I mean, it's really not that bad. Okay, let's go see what we can do on the tug up. There we go, both saws digging in and cutting good. Of course that 660 is really just walking away from it, but you gotta realize it's got 32, 33 more cc's than that 590. So I'm trying to point some special things out here. All right, now we're into the vice grip. Both of the saws digging in. And of course, the 660 walks away with the win. There we go. All right, shake it off, Hot Rod. You got some work to do, buddy. Yeah. Thumbs up. So the clear winner is the Steel MS660 or 066, whichever. Doesn't matter. But let's see what Bodie has to say about it, and maybe he can explain this a little bit better. Okay, so what you think of that? Probably at first glance, you're like, why would you even put these two saws together, Bodie? It's a good question. Hot Rod, he thinks that maybe he can get that 590 to perform close to or possibly even beat that 660. I don't know, maybe he can, maybe he can't, but basically this is a prelude to before Hot Rod ports the 590 Dire Wolf, what he calls the Dire Wolf. Anyways, so, things are rolling, I'm getting projects done, getting things out of the way, and, you know, it's summertime, guys, so there's not going to be a lot of cutting. It's freaking hot in Georgia. At least I'm not in South Georgia. It was even worse down there. Vegas too. I lived in Vegas. Jeez. So my point is, the video content of this channel during the summer months is largely going to be projects that I'm working on in the garage, which, you know, that is what it is. Maybe you'll like it. Maybe you don't like it. Whatever. Anyways, so the 590 is, you know, probably within the next couple weeks, I'll be able to get in on that. And I bet you I can make it run good. That 660, Don't get me wrong. I like a 660. 660s are good. And I can remember whenever I had mine, I had a clone, a 660 clone. And that was the biggest, baddest saw that I had ever ran. And so, of course, I was like, wow, this thing's awesome, right? And but then I ran other things, and I'm like, is the 660 all that awesome? It's a great saw. It has no real known problems that I know of. I mean, it's not like, like the 592s. I'm sorry, not 592, the 562s that I'm experiencing with the hot start issues and stuff. You know, this MS-660, it didn't have any problems like that I know of. And it's a really good, solid saw if you need to pull a long bar. It's a good saw. However, speed-wise, it really ain't that fast. It just ain't. Now, I'm sure if you ported it, some differences, but this one that Randy's got, it's got great compression, it's a good running saw, He's got a bark box on it and the Max Flow air filter, and it's 92 cc's. I would think that thing would be twice as fast as that 590. It's not. Yeah, it beat it. I think the 590 was cutting somewhere around 13 to 14 seconds in that cut, and the 660 was about 9 seconds. So it's got 3, maybe 4 seconds on it, something like that. So it is beating it. And if I can make that 590 compete with that 660, I'll have done something. It's, you know, that'll be a good port job. So that's what this is about. This is why I am doing this particular whack off, because I plan on porting the 590. I want to see what I can do. So I have set the bar. That's what I've done. I've matched it up against this. I've matched it up against this 660, and whenever I get done with the porting, we'll see. We'll see how it does. And that's about it. Here's the cylinder for Aaron's saw. It is, I'm very happy with this, guys. I keep getting better and better at my porting. Tim, you had mentioned something about chamfering the ports. I do chamfer the ports. And yes, I should tell people about that. It's very important to chamfer the ports. However, I chamfer them very little because I feel like... I mean, I wish I could. You could really see, but you just can't. You know, I guess you can see a little bit there on the exhaust, a little bit of a chamfer. But chamfer is basically it's whenever you're rounding off those hard edges, and you do that so that your ring doesn't get hung up on it, and if it can also score the piston a little bit, but. The deal is with me and chamfering is I barely chamfer, because if you have large chamfer, that screws up your timing numbers. So I'm really, I guess you could say kind of anal about trying to, I try and get my timing numbers right. And maybe that's a sign of me being pretty new to this. Maybe it's a sign of me being amazing. I don't know. I doubt if it's a sign of me being amazing. But, you know, I don't want to screw up my timing numbers with a big chamfer. And Tim, I'm not saying that you do that. I'm just blabbering. Blabber, blabber, blabber. But yeah, next time I do a porting video, I'll try and mention that. I'll try and mention the chamfer and my outlook on it and stuff. Look at this. You can really see this is the stock piston. And this is the one that I've already ported. Look how I cut out those piston skirts. That's just, yeah, all of that material right there, it serves no purpose. So, get rid of it. Anywho, I hope you enjoyed the video, and I guess that's it. Look at this. I installed, this is going to screw up green screen stuff. I installed a couple racks there. I have two big racks full of chainsaws. You can't really see them. Oh, look at all those beautiful chainsaws. All of these, basically all of these, are projects that I am working on. And eventually, hopefully, I'll finish. Hey. So, anyways, I guess that's enough for this video. What do you think? Well, that's only 13 minutes, man. That's going to be a short one. All right. Okay. Anyways, I'm out, guys. See ya.